How's it going? I hope you're having a good day so far. Welcome back to Elden Ring, the DLC. This is going to... So initially the plan was, okay, let's see how I do against the final boss fight. But just earlier today, they ended up buffing the Shadow Realm blessings. So overall, like, basically they just added better scaling to the earlier levels of the blessings, and once you get closer to the max level, it like really slows down. But they did end up buffing the last two levels of it. So when you max out your shadow blessing, you get a 105% boost instead of just 100%. Now I'm at level 15 shadow blessing, and according to a graph that was put out, right now that puts me at around, like, just under. It's a weird, like, in-between level between blessing level 18 and 19. So I think, like, the bonus is, like, 92.5% is what they said it was. Whereas it would have been 75% was what I was at. So right now, these are my new stats. Yeah, I got 75% damage negation. Actually, hold on. Let's see how good it is with Golden Bow. Damn, 78%. And then I've also got Braggart's Roar on top of it. That's pretty good, actually. So, I mean, initially the plan was just, you know, oh, let's go ahead, go to the final boss, see how I do against them. But now it's just, we're just going to fight them. Like, because I'm basically at the, like I said, it's equivalent to right in between, level, oh. Surface required ahead. Turn back and then seek right. but yeah, since we're at what's basically the equivalent of plus 19, we're just gonna go ahead and, assuming, you know. Oh, did I? I did activate that. Okay. Try right. No, I guess that would have been the left. But yeah, so we'll actually try left. I've been bamboozled. Both ways. Message was appraised. What did I put down? What did I... Oh, try throwing Elden Ring in the Volcano Manor. Fear. Well, you've got to face it eventually. Did I just not notice, like, something over here? Ah, yeah, there it is. Oh, you motherfucker! Piece of shit. That was a dude who was casting magic at me on the stairs. But yeah, so we're just going to go ahead and go right for the final boss and try and beat them. I mean, again, since I'm at fucking voids, since we're at basically level 19, I think we should be fine. Again, my brother beat it on New Game Plus at level 16 before we got the patch. So it should be fine. I want to hope so, at least. Because they didn't actually adjust, like, any numbers or things on the bosses themselves. It was literally just for, the Shadow Realm blessing. Oh, there's something on the roof there. I want it. So smithing stone 8. I mean, I guess if I find a different weapon and want to try that. Oh, you. Bitch. Where do you think you're going, huh? That'll learn you to try and live peacefully. Oh, another... Okay, cool. So I think that's, Spirit Ash plus 9, then. That just makes Luigi even better. I'm a Luigi, number one! Yeah, I mean, I could go get that, whatever it is. Silver Horn Tender. Someone cut you off on the road, and you swear to God the wolf was about to come out. you were gonna show them the inner demon. Horned Warrior Ashes. Oh shit. The absolutely broken piece of shit. And now you get them as a Spirit Ash. You don't fuck with a lichen. Yeah, what's the stupid ass saying? It's like the devil shivers when a nice guy loses his patience or something like that. Should have said something like that. Like, I can't remember the exact wording for it, but it's something precisely like that. The devil did more than shiver. I guess he cried. Oh, hey, speaking of, what the fuck is that? Why is he actually flying? Why did he actually fly? Alright. Bloodborne enemy? The only Bloodborne enemies that flew were the goddamn, like, fly things that would just jump up and try to grab you. Alright, well, now that I know that he's there, I should be able to just fuck him up with Braggart's Roar. Fuck those guys. Yeah, I don't like them either. But at least, you know, they're easier to, deal with than, you know, half the shit they like to throw at you in this game. Why am I hurting the birds? Because they're throwing shadow magic at me? Fuck the birds. Hater-ass bitches. Like, would you allow the bird to throw shadow magic at you? Would you be okay with that? Shadow is sick. Shadow the Hedgehog is sick. Those birds suck. Chaos Control? These birds are not using Chaos Control. Alright, where the hell is... There's the ladder. Alright, now I know to use Braggart's Roar and then jump down, but I should also... What if Shadow the Hedgehog showed up in Elden Ring? You know what? I would allow Shadow the Hedgehog to be bullshit if he was in Elden Ring, because it's Shadow the Hedgehog. That tarnished again, of all places! I found- Oh, wait, no, the tarnished doesn't say anything. So he would just start going on a rant about the tarnished being a faker. It's just an NPC. Alright, let's try this again. There we go. Yeah, these dudes are basically like mini-bosses, so you have to like actually prepare to fight them. Oh, it's beginning to look a lot like fuck this. They actually changed the weather. I love Frostbite. Frostbite is actually apparently like really good in this game. Like, on top of dealing instant damage, like, not as much as bleed, it deals instant damage, and then it also reduces your damage resistance by, like, 10% or something. Like, it's actually really good. This is like Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed, if it was any good. I'm still upset that they changed Assassin's Creed into like fucking open world Ubisoft slop. Like open world RPG Ubisoft slop. 2 is good. I really like 2, but then they milked it because they realized they finally made a good game. They were like, oh, dude, we finally made a good video game. Let's milk it for all it's worth. Oh, there we go. Now we finally got up the stairs. Ezio is sick. Ezio is pretty cool. The fuck? Where does this go? Who did that? Whomstative? Firelink Shrine. It all comes back to Firelink. Where the hell am I going? Bitch. She linked my fire because I treat her like a shrine. Sombert. All of that just for that. She ma all my jula till I... She round on my table till I hold. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, that was really bad. Okay, so this just went fucking nowhere. Who the fuck was throwing fire, though? Oh, there's something down there. I swore I saw... Blomp. Hate Twitch. Is it Twitch in general or just Twitch mobile? Be wary of strong foe. Uh-oh. Both? Okay, that's fair, honestly. Be wary of projectile weapon. It's another one of those fuckers. Alright, well, you know what? I actually have enough FP to do this. Because I have more mind now. Alright, let's go. Why can I summon? You know what? Screw it. We'll summon Luigi. That did, like, no damage. Wow. Oh, okay. I'm alive? Not anymore, I'm not. I thought I actually died before I stood up. The site always makes you have to log in even when you do remember me. Yeah, that's weird. I haven't had that happen before. Artorias? That thing is not Artorias. Well, I've got to go. Do I have to fight the first one again, too? Also want to point out, this is like a super tanky build. Like, since the buff, I have like 75% physical damage reduction. Lady Maria. Man, the dual bosses in this game wish they were as good as Lady Maria. How the fuck? Just get 100? I'm trying! What do you think I'm doing? Why do you think I put on all the defensive talismans I could get? Become evasion tank. I don't remember what was there. Oh, he's just right there. Okay. Wait, why did I do that? I did that backwards. Shit. All right then. I see. So part of his moveset is to actually reduce my frames. Got it. Naked run? I'm sure there's someone who's doing that. There's someone crazy enough that's doing that. That's not me, though. I am not that insane. Your final challenge. Make a balanced Elden Ring endgame. Nah, Jigsaw, yo ass tweaking. Like, again, I also want to point out that basically what I'm at right now is the equivalent to plus 19 on the Shadow Blessings now. So like on a full tank build and nearly at the max rank of the Shadow Blessings. Alright, let's try this again. Sounds like you just shouldn't get hit. Clearly. Clearly I should just avoid the giant AoE. The giant 17-hit AoE combo that the... What are you doing, buddy? There you go. And there's an explode. Why am I still getting staggered? Dude, I have like 100 poise. That's lovely. That one was rough to watch. It was rough to play. Like, okay, like genuinely. What's the point of poise if they're just going to ignore it? Like, yeah, he's got a two-handed sword. I should be able, like, I've got nearly 100 poise. And it's a one-handed moveset that the thing is doing. Like, I should be able to tank through that. I can tank through other bosses. Like, why is this thing more unbalanced than the bosses? Like, there's some things that just... There's some movesets that just... Oh my god! Fucking get down here. Like, there's some movesets that just genuinely feel like they just ignore, like, poise and just other game mechanics and shit. Like, there was actually, like, a video popped up in my recommended about, Millennia. And they were trying to analyze because, you know, this was back when... Millennia was the toughest boss fight in the game. And so there were complaints about her being completely bullshit and stupid. So somebody actually went through and analyzed, like, everything about her to see you know, if any of those complaints had any merit. And it turns out she actually just genuinely ignores gameplay mechanics that Elden Ring has, like, set in place to be, like, expected for boss fights and duels and stuff. Like, so one of the major things was that she has, like, hyper armor on certain moves and stuff. Why does that go so far? Like, she has hyper armor on certain moves, and typically, even on boss fights, if they do a move that has hyper armor, it'll still, like, if you stance break a boss, even during its hyper armor frames, it'll still get stance broken. Malenia doesn't do that. If you stance break her during a move where she has hyper armor, she just continues doing the move. Because fuck you. Why does my dude go, ah? That's my new ability, Braggart's Roar. It increases my damage done, it increases my defense, and it makes me regen stamina faster. What if it was called Swagger Roar? What if it was called Freaky Roar? What then, Trash? Alright, so this time we're just gonna summon the Mimic Tear right off the bat. Alright, and then heal up. And then Golden Vow. And the Braggart's Roar. Okay. Let's go, Luigi. You're using the Mimic, you aren't playing the game. You aren't playing the game correctly, you're using Mimic Tear. What the fuck? What? Oh, was that a command grab move? Okay. I legitimately, because of the goddamn... because of the goddamn Frost move where he, like, jumps in the air, I legitimately thought that was just another random move that he did. But no, it looks like it was just a command grab type move. But yeah, no, it's... Bitch did Incineroar up B. He did Incineroar... Oh my god, and there's a goddamn thing right here, too. That's funny. I died right before the grace. That's kind of funny, honestly. Another tree fragment. Okay. Should have just ran past. I really should have. Okay. Now we're actually at blessing level 19. Oh, there was another boss fight, like, apparently right before the final boss that my brother said was another, you know, air quotes, good game design boss fight. Traitor ahead, try ranged battle.
I see you here. It'd been quite some time. It was never kindly Mikula, was it? The Erdtree was leading you all along.
Yeah?
So that you might ascend to lordship.
Yeah?
I come to these lands to begin with. I suppose
I wanted to say hi to Mikula.
His eminence, or perhaps the Erdtree desired all along. The clashing of the
kill her heavy
lords.
Attack. I actually can't.
Such that one.
I actually can't.
So be it.
They turned on the passive
if you insist
thing.
Upon facing
like the same
Mikula
thing as in Roundtable Hold.
Then I will run you through whoever you might be. Don't tarry now.
They're probably upset that Oh, okay. Be summoned to challenge Needle Knight Leda and her allies. Okay. Like, they were probably upset about people just skipping Vati Vidya's monologue at the end of the game.
Don't you dare approach Mikula the Kind. Needle Knight Letter, Dryleaf Dane, and our ally will never allow this.
And our ally. The other guy just doesn't get a name.
Tis just as the woman said it would be. Lord of the Earth Tree. Lord of Marika. You too deserve to face the reckoning. Oh, Mikula, please.
Dryleaf Dane? No, but you gave me the martial arts moveset. What, why do you have hyper armor? Why did he have hyper armor?
Kind Mikula. In God.
Like, he's using the fast moveset. Why did he have hyper armor?
I spoke to you as a compatriot when we stood before the withered arm. Kindly, Mikula, make the world.
Okay, so that was the fight that he was talking about. It's literally just a gang squad. Welcome back, grave robbers from Dark Souls 2. DS2 rap fight. No, it's literally the Grave Robbers fight. That's what it is. Like, it's the Grave Robbers fight from the goddamn, the Poison King DLC. Dane's footwork, huh? That's true, yeah, I forgot. Elden Ring is Dark Souls 2, too. They're really committed to the bit of being Dark Souls 2, too. Alright, I want to see the Dane's footwork moveset, so I guess as soon as we get out of a passive area. Leda's armor. I mean, she wanted to fight, so she got a fight, messages. Ooh, big lift. Where is this going? Yeah, now I guess in a way you kind of have to admire Elden Ring's commitment to being Dark Souls 2, too. Like, even all the bad shit. There is no fun boss design here. You're going to die. Alright, let's check out Dane's footwork. All right. All right, so this is the... Demon Souls is also a game. I gotta play Demon Souls eventually as well at some point. All right, now what about the heavy attacks? All right, now two-hand it. That's definitely a mid, maybe a high. Block this overhead, loser. Yeah, block this overhead right at the end of the mid combo. Will I start with the mid or the overhead? What if they added infinites to Elden Ring? That's just the bosses. That's just the boss fights. Oh my god, look at that. Look at that overhead, dude. You can either delay it, or you can just do it instantly. Who's blocking that? You can go into either the low or the overhead. Who's gonna block your mix? How are they going to block your mix? Marvel vs. Capcom 2 Iron Man got added to Elden Ring. Light punch! Medium punch! This is Slayer? I don't have Pile Bunker, though. How could it be Slayer? Uh, I need like a quarter of a million. Do I have enough souls to use for that? Final boss time? I think this is it. Yeah, I think this is the final boss. You might just have to use one of the remembrances. Time to kill Vort. Ah, the true final boss of all the Souls series saga. Vort of the Boreal Valley. It's finally time. Darn, I actually don't have enough to level up. Okay, new plan. Wait, where's Spiral Tower? Spiral Rise, there we are. Your final challenge, Irithyll. I just wanna level up before going into the final boss fight, because I'm probably going to lose my runes. And since I'm so close to another level, like... First try? I don't think so. I don't think so. Like, my brother beat the final boss on New Game Plus, and he was like, this is the worst boss that From has ever made. It works, trust.
Put on, remove the cat ears.
Back down here. Oh my god! Alright, that's enough runes. Alright. Alright. That's... Is there a lore reason they evaporate? They're stupid, and they never figured out how to die properly. Alright, let's go. Here we go.
My loyal blade, and champion of the festival.
Skip cutscene?
Both your no. deeds will ever be praised in song. Now, the vow will be honored, and my lord brother's soul will return, so that he may be my consort.
Dueling Peaks? It's Dueling Peaks made out of dead bodies. That's kind of metal. Anyway, yeah, here's the final boss. It's Radahn. Again. Why is it Radahn? Okay. Godskin Trio? Yeah, no, that's the hidden final boss. Oh, okay. The fuck? Why is it still hidden? Oh my god. I didn't realize they used so much of my stamina. Yeah, I really should have Golden Bowed before. Jesus Christ, that does so much chip damage. Oh, phase 2.
I am all of me.
Hello, Robin. This looks like bullshit, but it also looks sick as fuck. Yeah. Am I all of me? Maybe? Like, I've heard phase two is actually, like, just garbage, so... Yeah. Yeah, like Robin says, here comes the really BS part. Like, I've heard phase two is just absolute garbage and, like, the worst boss fight that FromSoft has ever made.
Tarnished one.
Why doesn't Radahn even say anything? Old order. It's gonna be awful.
If you have known sin, if you grieve for this world, then yield the path forward to us. To I, Mikala, and my promised consort, Radahn.
The dog's out in full view. Yeah, that's just... Miyazaki just does that. Oh, what? I'm sorry? That's a command grab?
A 1,000-year voyage guided by compassion.
What does this do? And are you fucking kidding me? Why does every attack come with an AoE explosion now? Okay, fair enough. I'm sorry? Okay, just watching that move? How was I supposed to dodge that? What are you supposed to do during that? Okay, I do have the Halic Drake talisman. Die. Yeah, that's all you do. Just die. All right, that's fair. I'm surprised I had enough stamina to block all of that. That knocks me all the way back, so I can't. All right, there's the... Joke's on you for setting up. Yeah, I guess so. It actually seems like it's better to get hit by that because then you get the hard knockdown. So you get the hard knockdown invincibility. What the fuck is that? Oh my god, the frame rate. How are you supposed to dodge any of that? I thought he would get staggered. Okay, no, seriously. What is that moveset for phase two? Try getting naked? No. Now, does he just do this every single time I summon Mimic Tear? Yes, he does. At least I got Mimic Tear, though. Wait, why does he also do Blood Flame? What? Why does he also do... Don't set up, you'll... it's so fun, right? It's actually stupid, dude. Like, again, I want to point out, with the buff to the Shadow Blessings, to the Shadow Realm Blessings, I am technically at level 19. I am technically at Shadow Blessing level 19. What? That's his opening move always. Yeah, what's with the DLC bosses and the sudden, like, you know, fuck you, charge immediately to the entrance moveset? Like, what's up with that? At least here, I can summon the Mimic Tear, and then they don't do enough damage. Yeah, why does Radahn do Blood Flame? Like, what's going on? Why does Radahn suddenly have Blood Flame? Your fault for using Mimic Tear and not playing the game. Clearly, that's, looks miserable. Oh boy, this is stupid, actually. This is actually stupid. This is actually just, like... You know what? Honestly, probably the best idea is to just summon Mimic Tear right off the bat, because then, hopefully... Wait. I forgot to swap the... Okay, there we go. Yeah, there he goes. I missed him. Is he not? I thought he would be staggered at this point, dude. What? Why didn't I get the crit? Excuse me? Excuse me, video game? This is, like, actually genuinely awful. But it seems like the best bet is to actually just summon Mimic Tear at the start, even if I get hit, because I'm not getting the chance any other way. The phase two at like 75%. Why are the frames, dude? And he can just do that from full screen? You fucking kidding me? And he's got holy damage follow up on it, because of course he does. Why Why does he have a fucking full screen explosion every single thing he has? Why did he also not target the Mimic tier at all? Like, isn't aggro supposed to be split? This fight is genuinely... It is! Like, what the fuck am I supposed to... Even if I was fast rolling, how the fuck am I supposed to avoid this shit? Like, this is actually just... This is actually just stupid. Pray let me solo him comes to save you. That's what it feels like, dude. Also, again, why does Radahn suddenly have Blood Flame? Why is it that Radahn suddenly has Blood Flame attacks? Like, he did not use that shit. Why does he have bleed all of a sudden? Is there a lore reason Miyazaki decided that Radahn should be literally the worst fucking boss ever created? Is he stupid? Gotta be fucking kidding me, dude. I tried to do a heavy attack before I block, like, it buffed. Oh, he does the Artorias flip. Okay. Like, I buffered a heavy attack. Like, when I blocked that. But then I wanted to do a roll. Lore-wise, this makes sense, but for the sake of making a fun game... Yeah, no, for... This is just actually not fun. Now I've gotta fucking run for my life because he decided to do this move. Like, what? How am I supposed to follow that up? How am I supposed to attack him after all this shit? Because, like, look at it! Look at it, dude! When is it my fucking turn? When is it my turn? But every move he does that had an opening in the first phase, now all of a sudden, it's taken up by the goddamn, the exploding holy thing. So now, there's genuinely, like, no opening. Like, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Stagger. And of course, it got spaced out enough that I couldn't hit him with the guard counter. Elden Ring players, after getting killed for doing two light attacks after blocking for 3 minutes. But, my mistake. I see. I've gotten greedy here. Like, again, this is genuinely, like, what are the openings to punish those attacks? Like, what are supposed to be the openings there? The openings are as follows. Fuck and you, probably.
that, I probably just run from. Oh my god, target the fucking mimic! What the fuck? Like, dude. Connecting to chat. Radon is so bullshit that he's literally disconnecting me from chat. Okay, sometimes I get lucky and he just doesn't decide to jump at me immediately. Not even phase two. That'll put him into phase two. This will be the point you mute the music and put on Metal Gear Rising music. See, the thing is, you use Metal Gear Rising music for good boss fights. Oh, that's a command grab.
I promise you, a 1,000-year voyage guided by compassion.
I don't even know what that does. What does that even do? Why did it buffer a heavy attack? Oh my god. Another one?
Lord of the Old Order, let us go together.
What does that do? I actually don't know what... What? Huh? Hearts? What? Do I have to use his Great Rune? Do I have to use his Great Rune? Is that what it was talking about earlier? I can't even set it to a thing here. Can I even put it on equipment? Or do I just use it? How about this? What, is it? Is it another song or something? Where the fuck is the Great Rune? Where'd it go? Where the fuck is Mikola's Great Rune? There you are. Do I just use that? Do I just use that and does it just... resist that? he can... of course you can, after you've never done that before. Of course, now suddenly, when I find, when I do guard counter you, now you have a sudden free follow-up to your fucking flip. Of course you do! I love Elden Ring boss design. Okay, but no, there's got to be some way to put that, let Mikola's Great Rune on one of my equipment slots, right? Oh, there it is. Okay. So this is a good ending versus moment. This is actually another fucking good ending moment. Like, I'm sorry, this boss fight actually, like, genuinely sucks. This is actually just awful, dude. Like, this is just everything that was wrong with the end game of base Elden Ring. Like, so you can cancel that move into something else entirely as well. Oh, I love it. I love it. As soon as I try to dodge that attack, oh, just go into a completely new move that I've never done before. Ah, fuck, I think I'm dead. That's the command grab.
I promise you. A thousand-year voyage guided by compassion.
Okay, so I think now I've got to use his thing. But that's assuming, you know, he actually lets me. He let me. Okay, so that's what it is. Oh, he command grabbed my, Damn it, I didn't time it right. Fucking Christ. Of course he's gonna do the phase transition. Oh, Luigi's dead. Oh, I just couldn't get away from that. She couldn't get away from that because of how large the AoE explosion was. I chose to run one direction and there was just a wall. What you're hearing is more Danganronpa before more of this. No, I would much rather play this than Danganronpa. It's just that it's frustrating because, like... because it's just like, you know, again... the game does have good boss fights. This is just not one of them. Ah, shit. I ran out of stamina. Oh, and I don't even get the full crit. Come on, dude. Got Mimic Tear. Did the other follow-up instead. How did I even dodge that? I don't even know how I dodged that, dude. Of course. You know, because that was another time where I tried to guard counter. Oh my god, the frames, dude. I gotta heal. Why did I not hit him with that jump attack? There goes Luigi. Come on. What do you mean that missed? Are you fucking kidding me? How did that jump attack miss? How did the jump attack fucking miss? Hitboxes. Yeah, I got fucked over. Like, how did that fucking miss, dude? That was fucking bullshit. That's actually fucking garbage. That should have been the dub there. I dodged early and it still worked, so I'm kind of surprised by that. Okay, he decided to turn around in midair and target me instead. Okay, of course, you've got a follow-up to that. I'm surprised he hasn't phase transitioned yet. There he goes. Alright, here's the big fuck you explosion that also kills the frames. of course, you turned around and decided to slap me in the face instead. What do you mean? I dodged? Hello? I actually dodged that and he still hit. What the fuck? This boss actually fucking sucks, dude. This boss is actually garbage. This boss is actually trash, dude. It's so fucking bad. And it still hits me. What the fuck? I dodge it and it still hits me. Stance broke him, so there goes his stance getting reset. Alright, do your fucking move. Are you fucking serious, dude?
I promise you a 1,000-year voyage guided by compassion.
Alright, run away from him. That he's targeting Luigi. Genuinely, when am I supposed to actually, like, attack him, dude? Like, those added explosions just... Like, there's practically no window to actually hit him because of this. I'm stuck. I'm surprised I didn't hit, honestly. He decided to turn around mid-combo and smack me instead. Why can I not get the full crit? Like, come on, dude. Let the full crit play out. Alright, there's the bullshit. He has invincibility frames on the startup of that move? Are you fucking kidding me? He actually has invincibility frames. I didn't get fucked over by hitboxes during that one attempt. He actually just has invincibility frames. Luigi did it. Good job, Luigi. Good job, Luigi. I don't even feel satisfied with that victory, dude. I don't even feel good about that. That's genuinely just such a shitty boss. Wait, is that it? There's no, like, cutscene or anything? Nothing happens? Am I missing something? Oh, is there something over there? That looks like something. Touch memory. That's it. I'm actually annoyed. I'm actually so fucking annoyed. Circlet of light which adorned Mikola's head has returned in divine aspect, has begun to fade into nothingness. Slightly boosts intelligence, faith, and arcane, while also boosting the power of Mikola's light. Circle was to be the very foundation upon which Mikola's Age of Compassion would be built. Should it have ever come to pass. Alright, remembrance of a god and a lord. Remembrance of Radahn, consort of Mikola, hewn into the Skad tree. The power of its namesake can be unlocked by the finger reader. Alternatively, it can be used to gain a great bounty of runes. In their childhood, Mikola saw Radahn a lord, his strength and his kindness that stood in stark contrast with their afflicted selves. So Mikola made his heartfelt wish that Radahn would one day be his king consort. I'm actually just fucking annoyed, dude. I'm actually just straight up annoyed. I don't even know if I want to keep streaming. I don't even know if I want to keep streaming this. That boss fight just fucking sucked. Boss fight was actually just awful. Like, I genuinely see no way how are you supposed to, like, actually... Like, when is it your turn during the boss? Like... Every single attack he does had a follow-up with a holy explosion. And as a result, that just means there's no gaps in his pressure. And it's just like, at that point, you just have to get lucky. You just have to get lucky with the moveset and just hope that he... On top of the fact that, okay, he just has moves that just make him invincible. So, you know, that's fucking cool. That was just everything wrong with Elden Ring in one boss fight. That was actually... That actually probably was the worst fucking boss fight I ever played in a FromSoft game. That's, like, actually impressive. And in a series with bosses like fucking Bed of Chaos? Like, holy shit, dude. But it was just genuinely awful. I'm so fucking annoyed. I'm actually so fucking annoyed, dude. Like, at least when I beat Bed of Chaos, it was just like, oh, for fuck's sake, it's finally over. I beat that, and it's just like... I'm just pissed. I'm just pissed, dude. Like, I'm just so fucking irritated. Well, we still have plenty of bosses to go through, so maybe none of them are nearly as... Maybe they're not nearly as bad as the final boss is. Apparently there's... Like, I was watching Regiment, because he's also doing his own playthrough of it. He said there is a Frenzied Flame boss. I want to try and find that. I'm assuming it's over where all the fingers are. Now it's just a matter of figuring out how to get over there. Dude, I'm actually just so fucking livid. I'm actually fucking livid, dude. People will say, like, people who are, like, just, like, people who make their entire personality about beating Souls games will say shit like, you know, oh, skill issue and stuff like that. There is no skill issue involved with that boss. That boss fight is just awful. That boss fight is just not good. It's terrible. And the thing is, like, I saw something about Miyazaki saying that these were the hardest bosses that they've ever designed. And it's like, okay, they're the hardest bosses ever designed. Are they fun, though? The answer is no. Like, yes, Radahn there was a very difficult boss fight. Was he fun? Absolutely not. Was one of the worst fucking boss fights I've ever played. You know, in a series where they have boss fights like Lady Maria. Like, the most annoying boss fight purely from like an actual fight perspective, not like, you know, what you call it, gimmicks, I guess, like Bed of Chaos. The most annoying quote-unquote boss fight is probably Orphan of Kos, but even Orphan of Kos can still be staggered easily if you're using like heavy attacks. It can still be parried, and you can even trick its AI into doing a dive attack, so you can set up for a full charge attack on its back to to get a guaranteed crit follow-up. And even then, in Bloodborne, you are also able to be as aggressive as the Orphan of Kos is. And even though it can be annoying, it's still also really fun. Because, like, you know, it's annoying up until you learn, oh, I can go as batshit insane as Orphan of Kos can. Once you realize that, then you fucking go ham. Yeah, no, that was just fucking garbage, dude. It's a fucking awful fight. Actually, so fucking pissed. That's why I'm sitting here on the map for so long. Like, I just need to fucking, like, calm the fuck down. Because of how annoying that was. Jesus fucking Christ, dude. But again, I know, you know, there's an interview where Miyazaki's like, you know, oh, you know, if we made the games easier, then it wouldn't feel as satisfying. It doesn't even feel satisfying fighting them. Like, it didn't feel satisfying fighting Radahn. It was actually just so annoying. Okay. Yeah, enough of that. Let's try and figure out how to get to the fucking frenzied flame dude. Let's just try and find the frenzied flame guy and see if he's any better. I'm just, like, actually really annoyed. I can summon Torin. Okay. Is there, like, something that I missed along the way? Is there a ladder or something that I missed? I guess maybe I should change the stream title. There we go. All right. Okay. Okay. Now we try and figure out how we can get to wherever that leads to. You know what? Let me look up. Hold on. I know on the... Now, let me see if I can, like, actually, like... Elden Ring. Goes here. So maybe somewhere from here. Is there literally just another, like, direction that I could have gone? Is there another door that I missed? I can see the other side over there. It's so close. It looks like there's supposed to be something around here. Have mercy for the spirited away, shamans. Do I do... Do I try and do this? Ah, okay. All right, let's see. Where the hell is Gesture? There we go. Gesturing acquire ahead. Their like hidden path or something. Is there like hidden path or just path? I swear there's like a hidden path thing there, or there was. Beating to a pulp. There it is. Where is... There it is. There we go. Someone else also put it there. All right, so now we figured out. Now we've made it. Oh, that's a... It's a good thing that wasn't a really long fall. Wait, why can I summon? Okay. So I almost kind of want to... hi, Lele.
Bonk.
Bonk indeed, Lele. Honestly, I kind of just want to, like, make a beeline for, That's probably not good, is it? That it does, maybe it's just the map thing. I kind of just want to make a beeline for this Fingers place, because I think that might be where the Frenzied Flame dude is. What's going on, Lele? How you been? Alive? Ah, I feel that. I've had days like that. Hopefully it gets better, man. Oh, I guess I went the wrong way. Oops. Well, I'm here anyway. May as well see what's over here. Ah, bears. Da bears. Like, they're going to try and fight me, but they're only, like, going to give 100 souls if I kill them, so I don't care about fighting them. Alright, go back down here then. Because I'm an idiot and went the wrong way. This is a pretty area though. This is what I needed after dealing with that boss. This is a pretty little area. I needed this. Why are there... I love Elden Ring boss design. Here's two tree sentinels. I mean, I guess that explains why I could summon. Yeah, it's time for an adventure. We're going to the center of the fingers. We're gonna try fingers butthole. Although, what's in that big old crater over there, huh? What? Is this snake people or something? Alright, what's this then? Oh, I guess another boss fight, because I just saw the summon thing pop up. That something died, okay. Falling stuff. Are you dead ass right now? So one of the big complaints about the base game was the constant reuse of bosses and stuff. So what are you doing in the DLC? Reuse them some more. Elden Ring, I love you, but like... But like, you gotta, you know, fucking try Elden Ring. Well, that was just silly of me. Alright, cool. Do I at least get anything cool from him? Gravitational missile. Alright. Something at least. I mean, again, it's lame that, you know, hey, here's a DLC. Oh, we're reusing bosses. Like, I just saw two reused bosses. Back to back. Like... I love you, Elden Ring, but, like... Come on. Like, come on now. Oh, there's a bunch of hands. We're getting handsy today. It's just more mind. Why not? Yeah, there's all this yellow, but I don't have the buff that grants extra runes. So I imagine this is going to be, like... It's gotta be something related to the Frenzied Flame. Which, again, would make sense, since, you know, there's all the fingers. And I think for the Frenzied Flame, I think that was the three fingers were the ones, like... That caused it or something. Finger Ruins of Deo. What the hell is that? What are you? Okay, that's a Bloodborne-ass enemy. What the fuck? That's a Bloodborne-ass enemy. There's gotta be a Site of Grace nearby, right? They're even spitting, like, poison blood or some shit, dude. This is a Bloodborne-ass enemy. Okay, what if I just run? Is there another Site of Grace nearby? Like, if I just follow the path. Ow. Okay, well, we're at the center. Sound. Oh, the hanging bell. Oh. That's the thing the dude was talking about last stream. That's it? That's all we get from the finger ruins here? Is that actually it? No cool boss fight or anything over here? The only thing we get is Falling Star Beast and Tree Sentinel? There's gotta be... Map... Does Map Genie have, like, a map? Of everything? Like, I'm actually just looking up Map Genie. Like, they've got a pretty detailed, map of the, Of Elden Ring, so I think they also have a map. Yeah, they've got a map of the Realm of Shadows. Okay. There's gotta be something over here, right? There's not. There's actually not. There's actually not. Oh no. There's actually not. Okay, well, surely... Where the heck is the Frenzied Flame boss, then? You know, we're also gonna have to fight, gonna have to try and fight Bale. Try and fight him again. Alright, boss. Where the heck are you hiding? Oh! Okay. So it looks like it's in that area underneath the jagged peaks. So I need to actually get the I need to actually find the map fragment. Where the heck is that? Okay, so I think... maybe we can take the, The gravestones that, like, poke out of the wall. Oh. I'm sitting at the daytime. Screw this. And it's just raining anyway. Oh, that's bloodstained. Dude, piss off right now. Yeah, I mean, since we're basically at level 19 Shadow Blessings, like, at this point, we don't really need to, like, go around and actually gather the stuff. Like, I think we'll be fine if we just go, like, right to the bosses. Fucking jump, Torrent. Fucking kidding. Oh my god, why does Torrent get staggered so easily? Why doesn't Torrent have my poise? That looks too far to jump. Although, I don't see any bloodstains, so... Ah, okay, it wasn't. Resummon Torrent. Alright, so I think it's, like, this way-ish? this not the correct area? I should have passed time again until it was not raining so I could actually see what the hell is going on, dude. Oh, well, we got this. Something that we can do, at least. Dark light catacombs. Well, if it's dark, then it's not light. I might just have to look up that thing again. About where to find... About, like, the correct pathway through the DLC. Because there's so many, like, ways that you've gotta, like, discover where it's, like, you know... Oh, in order to, you know, get over here, like, you don't actually go over here. You gotta take a coffin, which drops you down over here, and then you go all the way like that. And then you can go out the back. Like, it's kind of whack. Oh, it is, like, very dark. Okay, I see why it's called... Calm the fuck down, Faust. I was gonna say, I see why it's called Darklight Catacombs. Oh, I should probably rest, actually. I'm missing some flasks. But yeah, I see why it's called Darklight Catacomb now. It's very dark. Spooky. I was expecting him to hit me, and he didn't hit me. Die. Seek lover not down. Sentry down! Why did it stop locking on? Turn on the lights. I'm very startled. Thank you. Alrighty then. I mean, I could... jump down there. But I want to see what's over this way. Oh, hello. Hello, friend. Hello, other friend. Die. Oh, one of these fuckers again. Oh my god, I hate these things so much. That thing's so annoying. A level one... Again, why does it give me... Oh. Ah, damn it. Visions of rolling skeleton. See, now I've got to go back up there, jump over the railing, and see what's in the little thing up above it. Otherwise, I'll be annoyed the entire time. Like, I'll never know what it was, and then I'll be just like, that one little side room that I never explored. All right, let's see what's up with it. Ah, treasure chest. Viridian Amber Medallion. That was kind of worth. That's just increased stamina. Which, I mean, that's pretty nice. Whee! Oh, there's a light in the dark. Get it? Because of dark like catacombs? Why did that miss? You've got to be fucking joking, dude. It's still going. I'm out of the room. You're fucking kidding me, dude. It's still following me? Why is the magic still following me, dude? Okay, it stopped. Welcome to the chat room again. OBS, what are you doing? Alright, where does this lead to? To another... Oh, I can turn the lights on. Cool. Yeah. Wait, is this? Ah, I see. Indeed, yes, indeed. I'm not actually sure this will be the finale. Like, I want to beat Bale, and then I also want to fight the Frenzy boss. The Flames of Frenzy boss. If we do manage to beat both of them, like if I manage to find my way to the Flames of that's all, folks. If I manage to find my way to the Flames of Frenzy boss and beat both him and Bale in the today, then I guess tomorrow we'll start whatever won the vote. Oh, he just died. Okay. Oh, I missed. Forked tongue hatchet. Oh, is that just an upgrade of the... Not this fucking guy again. Jesus Christ, dude. Such an annoying fucking enemy. Such an annoying enemy, dude. Oh, that dude had two giant crushers. Hell yeah, brother. I've only got the one. Oh, no. Oh, no. Where is the exit? Where is the exit? Where is the exit? There's something over there. Run. Fucking run. Help me, iframes. Another one? Why? For what purpose? Okay, I at least can... I can get to him. Got his ass. Great Ghost Glowfort. Okay. Well, I guess we're going down. Yippee! Oh, treasure chest. Oh, and a ladder. Big Mouth Imp Ashes. So I've got the portable rocket dispenser as a spirit ash summon now. Okay. That's kind of funny. That's kind of funny. I guess just, yeah, like that. Ooh, lots of candles. Going even further down. Good lord. I mean, I guess you needed some way to get to the bottom of the map. Oh, that's a Steak America. Alrighty then. Elder Inquisitor. Stop that? Oh my god, oh my god, why am I just stuck in stagger? Of course he teleported away. Where are you? That's right. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Alright, so now... it's kind of cool looking, all the trees and shit. Is this enough? Yes, it is enough for another level up. There we go. All right. Let's go, Torrent. All right, now we can finally... what just happened? I don't believe it. The spectral steed is frightened. Oh, okay. Torrin is just scared. All right. Okay. So we just go then, I guess. Abyssal Woods. Oh, there's another Site of Grace, at least. What's this? Don't let it see you. Once you are seen, there is no escape. It cannot even be touched. Oh, fabulous. I guess I should turn off my lantern then. God required ahead. Message ahead. Time for turn back. Be wary of turn back. No regret ahead. Strong foe ahead. Yeah, what the hell are you? Are you the strong foe ahead? Are you the thing that can't be touched? Madding hand. Oh! He actually builds madness build up with each hit. Madding hand. Causes madness build up. That's kinda cool, actually. That's kinda cool. Be wary of invisible sort. Message ahead. Alright, yeah, there is the map over there. Man, it's dark as hell, huh? I mean, I guess that's why it's the Abyssal Woods. Madness Rat. Goodbye, Madness Rat. Alright. Where's the map? There's the map. Now, what the heck is this? Even the goat has, like, the madness eyes. Like... Map Abyss. Oh. Oh, there's another map I haven't found, huh? Okay, then. Abandoned church. Some fragments. Frenzy Flame perfume bottle. So that's gotta be a faith thing, right? No, of course, it scales with dexterity. Why wouldn't it? Alright, so I think the Frenzy Flame boss is down, like... Yeah, it's down, like, around this-ish area. So let's just go. Yeah, I like that even... Oh, that's... Okay, okay. Being near them builds up frenzy. Okay. So we gotta avoid the goats as well. Alright then, but what about the invisible sort that they were talking about? What's that all about, huh? is. We'll just keep going this way. This is a cool area. This is a cool area, honestly. Like, I was kind of hoping that, like... Oh, is that the thing that it was talking about? Quietly await your chance. Combat is not an option. Hide yourself. Make not a sound. Try parrying? Crouch in the undergrowth? What? You want me to be like Sekiro? Sekiro? Elden Ring's die twice? Fear, oh fear. Oh, those must be the shadows of the Erdtree. Stealth is a vital part of Metal Gear Online. Winter Lantern Fly? Winter Lantern. Okay, Elden Ring. Welcome back, Bloodborne. If you don't know, these things actually do look very similar to an enemy in Bloodborne called Winter Lanterns. They were the brain dudes that would, Oh, you can do that and force them to run over there. Oh, okay. That's neat. Oh, that's cool. That's actually cool. You can, like, bait them into a specific bush and then run to another one. That's cool. You know, especially since, like, stealth hasn't really been used in Elden Ring that much. Like, it's like, you know, it's there. It's an option. You can do that. But, like, there hasn't really been any, like, real, like, stealth segments that you had to go through. Like, this is cool. This is cool, actually. Like, that's actually really cool. Oh, now it's all foggy and stuff, too. Try left. Like, this is cool. This is cool. Oh, I think that's it there. Yeah. Like, this is a cool little segment. Like, what are you doing, Elden Ringo? Like, this is a cool little segment. Like, I'm liking this. Like, again, like, they introduced stealth and then it was just like not really a thing that they actually took advantage of in the games. Like, it was just kind of a thing that was there. Alright, I think we're getting closer to the flenzy frame boss. Yeah, the flenzy frame. Dude, this is so cool, though. Like, having an actual, like, stealth sneaking segment. Although I do wonder if you actually could just, like, run by everything, or if they're, like, so fast that you can't actually outrun them. Although the one thing did say try parry. But I've never really been that good at parrying, so I kind of don't want to try. What's all this? Hello? Red? Oh, the frenzy eyes. You know, I haven't seen any nearby, so we might be fine to just kind of... Oh, just as I say that, look what it is. Yeah, look what's there as soon as I say something. Oh, that don't look like the frenzy flame things. Although, yeah, it don't look like the winter lanterns. It just looks like a regular... Are you a regular enemy? Yeah. Yeah, it's just a regular enemy. Alright, so... Okay, yeah, it's just another... Wait, can I even... Okay. Yeah, it's just regular mages. Like, these guys aren't allowed to fight. It's specifically the ones that look like the brain enemies from Bloodborne. Oh, they gave me a heal. How nice of them. Alright, oh, some orange flowers. Orange like the frenzied flame. Ah, light. Oh, what's this? Mad Craftsman's Cookbook, huh? I went all this way. Is this not even the right way? Was this not the right way to the thing? To the boss? I don't think I'll survive that if I drop down. I gotta go find... Yeah, there's some bloodstains here. Let's go find a point where I can drop down a little... Maybe right here? Yeah, this looks good. Okay. Now let's go this way. Oh, you know what? Is that a... No, I think I can jump up that. Yeah. Okay. Oh, village. What's up with the village here? Are the residents evil here? How many of them are there? Four? Okay, it doesn't look like there's any of the Winter Lanterns. But I might... Okay, well, hopefully this fall doesn't kill me. Yeah, okay, good. Oh, look, the front gate, right there. Let's go see if these residents are evil. Oh, we can't open it, can we? Oh, wait, no, we can. Hell yeah. There we are. I don't think I will.
No closer. No closer, I say. The man is worse.
This resident seems pretty evil. I should do something about that. Hey, buddy. What's up? I welcome you, oh uninvited guest. But I must warn, as you venture in, heed the words of our great master, Midra. Approach not the madness, lest ye succumb. Nah, I'd win. Cannot open from this side. Well, alright then. I guess I wouldn't win. I guess I was incorrect in my assumption that I would win. Wait. Side room. Pillage the swollen grape. Huh? Material used for crafting items. Eyeball of the frenzied flame that has swollen from within. Material used for crafting items. Marked with fingerprint burns, proof of having been touched directly by the Three Fingers' embrace. Yeah, the Three Fingers, that's what I was talking about. They're the ones, I'm pretty sure, they're the ones that, like, created the frenzied flame. It's just a bunch of Fortnite. Alright, well, let's see if, I guess maybe do I go around it then? Futility ahead, but praise the research. We'll see about that. The bitch. He saw my jump attack getting ready and then hid behind a tree. Okay, so maybe there was futility ahead. Alright, let's try the other side then. Unless there's, again, another room that I just completely missed in the mansion here. Time to go off to the other side. What do you have to say, buddy? No item ahead? Well, darn, so... Did I miss something? I mean, there's even a little hill up here. It is very dark in this game. Well, in this part of the woods, at least. Let's turn on the light. Dang, so there really is just... So I guess I must have missed something inside of there. Because I don't see anything. There's got to be something that I missed in there. But there's another open door that I just completely missed. Like... Yeah, no, that's not even an open window. Port. Who is dying here? Do I hit the ghost? Is that what it is? Try attacking? Ah, I see. Thank you, message. Oh my god, the frames. Alright, we're in a very evil residence right now. Torn diary page. Is this gonna explain how the residents were evil? I touched him, but only once. That is a very, very sus opening line. When he thrust his staff in my face, I brushed it aside. It was then that I touched him, the aging untouchable. Huh? I think we need to get Chris Hansen in here. Another swollen grape. Why is OBS constantly saying connecting to chat? Or, yeah. Yeah, it kind of ends there. That's a lot of bloodstains. Oh, that's why. Get him. There we go. Got his ass. I was about to say, there's a lot of bloodstains here. What could I have possibly died from? And then that dude tried to fucking jump me. Alright. Where's the rest of these evil residents? What the fuck is... Huh? The fire is alive. Okay, I'm not even... I can't even do anything about it. The fire is just alive. The fire is alive and it's pissed. You have fun over there, buddy. I'm gonna leave. Oh, they just kind of spawn in, huh? Well. That works, I suppose. Man, these are some really evil residents. Seek lever. Okay. just gotta find where the lever is. Well, they've even got the zombies. This really is Resident Evil. I can't believe it. We're actually in Resident Evil right now. This is kind of great. It's actually just Resident Evil, but in Dark Souls. Resident Dark Souls. Shadow Realm rune. I beg you to stop. Haven't I taken enough? Are we not brethren, common in our line? And yet you offer only cruelty. I ask, what crime did great Midra commit? He was mid. That's why his name is Midra. Oh. It's a spooky zombie. More of you? Wait, is that the dude? Was he actually the one casting that? I thought it was just... I thought it was just doing that. Surging frenzied flame. Oh, there's a ladder. A doy dingus. All right. Oh, yeah, I see the grace. Something in there, but I should really get the grace first. I should really get that first before trying to go into any of these hidden paths here. Yarr. Someone's having a fun time. Oh, hello. Oh boy, is this another platforming segment? Is this the beginning of the mansion? I don't think so. Do I just jump onto that thing, I guess? I guess I do. I don't see anything else. Okay. Shadow Realm rune, very nice. There you go, perish. There's another purple here. A swollen grape, of course. This looks like I need another lever. Now, where is the lever? Hey, you! Get out of here! Get the fuck out of here! You too. Shortcut ahead. Oh, is this back to the first grace? Yep. I think this is this is the first grace. All right, cool. Try striking. Oh. Hold on. Aha, ladder. What a thrill. Oh. What a thrill. There's the lever. Up, oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Get. There we go. Oh, you know what? Now I can jump on there. Hell yeah. What is over here? There's gotta be something good over here, right? Nanaya's torch. Feeble Lord's frenzied flame causes madness buildup. Hold out torch in front and spit out frenzied flame. Afflicts those caught in the area of effect with madness, along with the user themselves. Oh. Can be used while moving. That's kind of cool. So it really does seem like they want it to, like, oh. Hello, you. So it really does seem like they wanted to supplement more, like, builds with the items in the DLC. But then they also, you know, made shit like Radahn. Oh, another Revered Spirit Ash. Nice. Alright, let's see. Let's see what's up with that door behind, behind the bookcase here. Oh, is it just up to the door that I just walked by? Yes. Well, it never hurts just to make sure. Oh, hello. That did, like, no damage, damn. Oh, you know what? I really should... Oh, I do have it on. Okay. I was gonna say, I should really swap to the Fire Drake Medallion or the Flame Drake Medallion, whatever. Oh, hello, buddy. But I was already on it. Another grace. Kick ladder. All right. Alley-oop! There we go. Oh, nice. Wait, is that... Oh, we're at two. I need two more. At least I think I need two more. The last upgrade required four Spirit Ashes. So I'm just assuming... You good, buddy? Hang on, I'm gonna... Hold on, I'll be right there. I'm gonna rest. He's having a great time. You good, buddy? You having fun?
Depths of your foolishness!
Yeah? Oh. Oh, this is the dude from the trailer. Where it looked like he was about to rip off his head.
Enough. I have endured more than enough.
Oh, is he actually going to do it? Oh. He's actually going to do it. Oh, shit.
You forgive me. Dearest Nanaya.
Oh, oh. Okay, obviously they had to censor it. And now he's gonna beat me to death with his own spine. Oh, that's so cool. That's sick, dude. That's fucking cool, dude. Please don't be a shitty boss. What's happening here? Oh shit. Holy shit. Okay, okay. Calm down, buddy. Two guard counters into a riposte. Damn, guard counters are pretty fucking strong, huh? Oh, wow, he has, like, no stance. Wow, that was actually a pretty good boss. Wasn't annoying as shit or anything. They actually had a pretty good moveset that you can actually, like, properly counter and stuff. A wild departure from fucking the final boss. Alright, what's his lore? Hewn into the Skadu tree, the power of its namesake can be unlocked by the finger reader. Alternatively, it can be used to gain a great bounty of runes. As the golden barbs inflicted internal agony upon him, Midra held fast to Nania's entreaty, endure, that the word was a curse. Damn. They said thug it out, and he said, alright, I can thug it out. I'm based, I'm not cringe. Alright, I guess we can go fight Bale. And that'll honestly probably be it, unless... Hold on, let me check and see if there's, apparently something here called the Mother of Fingers. Apparently, I have to do the quest from the dude in this thing here. Alright, well, first, let's go and fight Bale the Dread. Let's go ahead and fight him first. I remember, like, we tried to fight him before, but we were at, like, level 4 Shadow Blessing. Thank you. Alright, let's see how he feels this time. Oh, shit. Alright. From hell's heart, I stab it. Oh my god, he has so much health. Yeah, maybe I should have both the fire and the lightning talismans equipped instead of just the pearl drake thing. Pushed me away from hitting him. Alright, he's about to transform. I used all my stamina. Shoot. Just run. Where is he? There he is. Wait. Oh, there he is. I dodged right into it. Oh, okay. Of course, there's a secondary explosion for the fire. Luigi, fuck him up, dude! Holy shit, dude. Oh, is it phase three? It looks like it's phase three. Oh, Luigi's dead. And I'm out of healing. Come on, he's almost dead. From hell's heart, I stab at thee! Ow. Alright, GG easy. Not even close. Not close whatsoever. Alright, now I guess we do... that other side mission for, what you call it? Yeah, Ymir, I think his name is? Yeah. So we go back to him. go ahead and talk to him again.
Oh, there you are. The exalted timbre of the bell has reached these ears of mine. Gracious, the starry sky is wondrous tonight indeed. Only your fate shines brighter. But fate can be a strange thing indeed.
Yeah.
The hanging bell you sounded was not the one on the map I gave you.
Oh, oops.
The bell you found was in fact here. Please take a second look at the original map, and may the gleaming stars guide you evermore. May the gleaming star...
Alright, so what was the... Okay, it looks like it's back in... the Jagged Peak. I hold on, let me. Hold on, I have to actually. There we are. Yeah, okay, so we go here. It looks like there's one more, like, legend boss. And that's the, the Mother of Fingers thing. What you mean? If it's the Mother of Fingers, that sounds pretty important to the lore, so I want to see what's going on with that. Alrighty then. Let's go ahead and... Alright, so it looks like... Yeah, we just have... bridge we cross here, and then we go... to this big old puddle here. Sorry, I'm just following the map. Like I said, I just wanna... I wanna fight the Mother of Fingers, and I think that's like... basically it, actually. Damn. And we go this way. I hope, at least. The hell? That's a big fucking goat. That's a big fucking goat. I think we go through here, and then there should be an opening on, like, the left. That's so fucking cool, dude. Holy shit, that's fucking cool. It's the fucking huge dragon. Yeah, okay, we want to go down to the fingers there. Holy shit. That's fucking all. Like, I was about to say something looks like a wing up ahead, and then you see that. Grand Altar of Dragon Communion. Oh. Priestess Heart. What can we get from here? Communion with Baal. Channels the Dread Dragon to roar with a heat wave blast. Channels Dread Dragon to strike with flame lightning infused talon bone. Okay, well, what's that priestess heart that I picked up? turns human frame into ancient dragon and boost. Dragon form? Use while disrobed to turn one's human flesh into an ancient dragon. The change cannot be undone except by death. Using this heart while already transformed temporarily boosts incantations of the capital's ancient dragon cult. Priestess was once an ancient dragon herself, but sacrificed that form for feeble flesh to aid the destruction of Bale the Dread. Okay, so dragon form is actually an install for faith builds or faith arcane, whatever. That's fucking cool! That's fucking cool, dude! Like, holy shit, that's fucking awesome! That's so sick! I mean, again, like, you know, yeah, we had dragon forms in the other FromSoft games. But, like, now it's actually for spellcasters instead? That's pretty cool. Hello, Zambinos. Trying to see. Yeah, no, I don't actually have the map for this area. You know, maybe do I go back to the dragon altar, and then is there, like, another pathway where I can, like, jump across that or something? Because I didn't see any caves or anything. There's more Zambos. Okay, so maybe... nothing there. Oh, what's that? Igon's cookbook. Dragon Communion Grease. Dragon Communion Harpoon. What does that grease do? Fire grease, blood grease, dragon communion, granting potent anti-dragon effects. Okay. Looks like there's something up that way. There's just another dragon over there. It looks... Oh, no, they're dead. Never mind. I was like, oh, shoot, it's another dragon. Oh, it's dead. Dragon communion grease. Yeah, where the heck is the way down? Like it's over this way, maybe. a big old field of blue over there. Da ba dee da ba da, da ba dee da ba da, da ba dee da ba da. But now, how do I get down there? And now we gotta find a way to get down there, is what's up. I do not think this bodes well. I don't think this is the correct way. Suffice it to say, I don't think this is the correct way. Harrow's Hidden Grave. Ooh, neat. Let's see if we can find what this is. This is pretty. This is a pretty area. I might die if I jump down that way, so... Wait. I think I'll be fine. Yeah, I was fine. I was doubting myself when I was falling down there. Cerulean Coast. This is a pretty area. This is really pretty. This is pretty. There's the last map fragment, I think. Map found. Let me see it. What am I in combat with? There's fucking nothing, dude. There's literally nothing around. What am I in combat with? Oh, hey, another cross. But genuinely, what the fuck am I in combat with? I don't get it. I abandon here my doubt and vacillation. All right, so I think this gets me to 97.5. There we go. Alright, so I think we go this way. It's looking like this way, at least. Like, if we go here and then kind of like that. At least I'm hoping that's the case. Yeah, it looks like we can just drop down here. Okay. Oh, big ol' hands. I ain't fighting them, though. Later, fellas. There's gonna be like a fucking dragon that jumps out somewhere, isn't there? This is a very pretty area. This is very pretty. Look at all the blue. The blue looks so nice. Alright, yeah, and then we can go up here. we should be able to go, like, to the little, what you call it. Oh, what's this? Brave Glow for. Okay, cool. Yeah, there we go. The Finger Ruins of Rhea. Oh, there's fly people. Oh, no, that's not fly people. It's just more hands. I thought it was fly people. All right, and then we need to go to, like, the center of this area here. These weirdo things again. Yeah, then we go to the center here, and then we... And we blow on this horn. Now, these big fingers, I was kind of hoping there was, like... Oh, alright. I was kind of hoping there was, like, more to them. Like, like, you know, it's a cool area and everything, but, like, that hit? Oh my god. Does it just spawn random dudes to try and eat me? Oh my god. This is annoying. Fucking serious, dude. This is actually really fucking obnoxious. Holy shit. But yeah, like, I was kind of hoping there would be, like, more to these little, like, finger ruins areas. I mean, again, this is leading to a boss called the Mother of Fingers, so hopefully it's cool. Alright, let's sound the bell. Alright, now we can go back to the guy.
Why, you poor thing. Another bad dream, Muri. Put that rotten thing out of your mind. That tangled mess can't hurt you.
Why are there a bunch of bloodstains?
Hello there. I heard is that another fingers? Sound, colored by your essence. Simply exhilarating, I must say. The stars are dark tonight. But rest assured, this is no ill omen. On the contrary, I believe that this portends a magnificent starry cascade. Now, take this. My final gift to you. May you join the glimmering stars above.
Okay, and then... I think it said to reload the area. Hold on, let me go ahead. Reload the area and interact with his throne. Okay.
Oh, yes. This evening... May you join the...
It says interact with his throne. Maybe do I... quit game and then reload? Is that what it meant? Try continuing here.
Oh yes, this evil. I fear that you, the conceits, is there not the answer never was? Marry us, and this is no man we have. Ever young,
oh, do I ask knew
that isn't tried that he would feel in the blame. Do you recall that Marika? Well, it is their mother. The fingers we all are new. I am. We studied that are you long ago.
Maybe I have to.
Is that not? And yet, may you join.
Okay, now that I've talked to him, maybe now? Okay, yeah, he's gone now. Okay, I just had to talk with him first. Okay, there we go. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na. And we go all the way down. Finger ruins of Mir. It says, sound the bell in the area below and be taken to the boss fight. So, okay, I should buff up before. Oh, hello. Okay. Cool, I guess. And now, let's go ahead and buff up. And then we sound the bell. There we go. Okay. All right. All right, let's go, Luigi. Mother of Fingers. Okay. I was kind of hoping for, like, a cutscene or something. Oh, I thought that was going to be a command grab. Lasers? Frickin' fingers with frickin' laser beams. Oh, is that a phase two? Is that a phase two? Now it's got an eye. Grant us eyes. Cleanse us of this beastly intellect. What? Beyblade? Beyblade? Let it rip. I missed. No! I wanted to try and hit it before. Black Hole Sun. What the fuck, dude? Okay. There we go. I defeated the fingers. The fingers are no more. Okay, that was pretty cool. We did it, Luigi. We saved a Mushroom Kingdom. The power of its namesake, the mother of all two fingers and finger creepers, was in turn a magnificently gleaming daughter of the greater will, and the first shooting star to fall upon the lands between. Okay, why wasn't there like a cutscene or something, man? Why wasn't there like a cutscene? Alright, it looks like there's one more legend boss. It's the Putrescent Knight. It looks like I have to go back to the blue flower area. Okay. So we got one more legend boss to do. So overall, the DLC was fine, I suppose. It was okay. You know what? Do I have... I don't know what the Putrescent Knight does, but, do I have, like, the Great Shield Medallion? Bitch! Really? That dinky little thing is what knocked me off of Torrent? It does not look like I have the Great Shield Talisman. Shortens casting speed for sorcery and incantations, but increases damage taken. Yeah, we'll not use that. I'm gonna guess this is gonna be, like, magic damage or something. I probably should have put that on for the Mother of Fingers boss fight, too. I love these blue guys. They're just vibing. Well, except the ones with the red heads. They are very much not vibing. And there's a giant. And it does sleep. Maybe that's what the knight is gonna have. Something died. Oh, he's still trying to kill me. I'm trying to find where this thing is. Ah. There we go, we just run back here. Oh, hey, Lele.
Thank you, Twitch. Very cool.
Twitch is very cool. I agree. What's happening, Lele? Lunchtime? Nice. You get anything good? Oh, did we go down there, I guess? Is the giant still throwing the sleeping pots at me? Is there a Site of Grace up here? Darn, there is not. Tired and customers... are like the Schrodinger cat, but What does that mean? Like, the Schrodinger's cat was the whole, like, you know, until I open the box, I don't know whether or not the cat is alive. Like, what's Schrodinger's cat for the customer? I don't know if the customer is alive or dead until they talk to me. Alright, I guess we just go into this. You try to help them and they make it harder. Oh. Yeah. Yeah, I've definitely had customers like that before. I mean, most of the ones that I had were pretty, like, chill. But there were some where it was just, like, you know... It doesn't matter how much you explain it to them. They just assume that you're trying to, like, make things worse for no reason. And, like, I don't understand, like, I don't think, like, those people, like, understand that, like, you know, if we deliberately were trying to make things worse, we would go out of business, like, immediately. I guess I can just drop down here. Yeah, it looks safe. This Arabic dude asked for help getting new lights, and you need to know the car type and year. He had the car and type, but you asked him for the year, and he kept asking how much money. And then you have to explain to him, I can't know until you actually, you know, give me all of the information that I need. Oh. Stone coffin fissure. What was the point of the Site of Grace back there if you're just gonna put another one right here? Elden Ring. What do you think you are? Dark Souls 3? Which I'll have to check and see, but I think Dark Souls 3 is gonna end up winning the poll. Like, once we beat this boss, this is gonna be it for the Elden Ring. Like, this is actually... I didn't think it was going to be this quick. This is actually going to be the final stream for Elden Ring. But I think Dark Souls 3 was winning on the poll. So we're probably going to end up doing Dark Souls 3. Oh! Okay, then. Thank you, Dark Souls 3. Even another customer that was there was looking at him like he was an idiot. Yeah. Well, my favorites were the ones that were argue, like, when I was still a cashier, they would argue, like, you know, oh, why can't you take my coupon? It's expired. It's literally been expired for 3 years. I'm not taking a 3-year expired coupon. And then they start causing a commotion. And the customer behind them... I literally actually had this happen. I think it was another customer's line. Or not customer. Another cashier's line. Someone was, like, you know, pissing and moaning about how they wouldn't take the coupon. And so the customer behind them is like, if I give you a quarter, will you get the fuck out of here? You refuse to be a cashier, you hate people. Honestly, that's probably the correct call. Alright, what do we have here? Kindly Mikola. Bitch? Oh my god, I can't fucking hit him because I'm in conversation. Alright. Mikola, I see you've thrown away something you should have not have under any circumstances. How will you salvation offer to those who cannot be saved? When you could not even save your other self. I don't know, buddy. Another skadoosh fragment. I abandon here my love. Oh. He lost his love. Yeah, no, that was also, like, the first job that I worked at. They tried to get me to be a customer service desk person. And I just laughed in their face. I said, fuck no, dude. I was like, are you kidding me? I fucking hate the customers. Like, the other store, like, the first store that I worked at, like...
Skill issue.
Sound alert. Skill issue.
Skill issue. Like, it was just, I was just dead ass. I was like, no, I fucking hate the customers here. Like, because the first store that I worked at, yeah, we just had the most obnoxious customers that would shop there. Like, you know, the one complaining about the coupon for 25 cents that was, like, 3 years expired. Like, the second job, it wasn't that bad. That is a real ass eye. The Rock actually has eyes now. I don't like that. I don't like that. They should not be having eyes. You guys should not be having eyes. Oh, and now they shoot lasers. The eyes shoot lasers. Goddamn rocks with their laser eyes. Oh, it's not dead. Oh, wait, no, it is. Okay. Another laser eye rock. Stop that. But yeah, honestly, I think it really just depends on the store, honestly. Like, cause like I said, like the first store that I worked at, I hated the customers there. The second one was like perfectly fine. Like every now and then you would get an asshole, but like they were the exception, not the norm. Another Sight of Grace. Welcome back, Dark Souls 3 level design. As much as I love Dark Souls 3, there were bonfires everywhere, dude. It was kinda insane. It was also really goofy at times, because there was like... Oh my god, there's like after like the old Dragon Slayer armor. Like, for every boss that you kill in Dark Souls 3, it spawns a bonfire in its arena so that you can immediately, like, use your bonfire like Yu-Gi-Oh! Sure, exactly like Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh, okay, now they're shooting flaming rocks, okay. But yeah, like, after every boss, it would spawn a bonfire in the boss arena, just so that like you could immediately spend your souls and stuff. And then there would be like really silly things where like, you know, there would be like a little, you know, corridor that links to another area of the game immediately from the boss arena. So then it led to silly things like you know what, I'm not going to bother killing it. Like, in the old Dragon Slayer armor, like, it was on a bridge. Oh, that's a big slime. That's a big slime. Is that a Mistbegotten? It's just being... Okay. Die. Multi-layered ring of light. But yeah, so like it would spawn, the bonfire would spawn on the bridge, and then immediately afterward, once you got off the bridge, there was another bonfire. You could literally see both bonfires on screen at the same time. Like, that's just how goofy it was. And again, I still absolutely love Dark Souls 3, but it was just like, it was silly. It was silly how many bonfires they placed so close next to each other. Bonfire is a spell card that when activated, it searches for any level 4 or lower pyro monster. I mean, yeah, sure, totally. That's exactly what bonfires do in Dark Souls 3 as well. Alright, I guess this is to the boss fight. What's up, buddy? Oh, please grant me the courage to fly to your feet, my dearest, Saint Trina. First off, jumping. Try down. Alright, sure. What have I got to lose? There's a sight of grace for- Oh, this is actually what I was supposed to do. Oh, okay. Alright, where's the dude? Oh. He's somewhere. I don't see him, but he's- Oh, there he is. Oh, boy. He's one of these bosses, huh? Frostbitten now. Alright, well, GG. Alright, and that's all of them. That's all the bosses. Well, all of the major bosses. Oh, where does this lead to? I guess we should see what this leads to. Yeah, we did. We did all the legend bosses. We did it. We beat the DLC. Wait, what level did we end at? 195. Alright, where does this lead off to? Why is it always weak foe? Oh, we can't attack here. Saint Trina's Blossom. Negative resistance versus Pierce? Saint Trina's life withered and fell, as fleeting as the seasons. At her last, she left a single water lily. Slightly boosts max SP. Despite the velvety blue-purple hue, the flower is in no way poisonous. It merely blooms in quietude. Time for sleep. Visions of love. Oh, is this supposed to be Saint Trina? Oh. Didn't expect bloodstain, so to speak. Could this be a strange sort? They just kind of fucking die. Saint Trina Disciples Cookbook. Lolling Branch. What does that do? Slowly builds up sleep while gradually restoring FP. Try fire? I can't. I mean, okay, I guess that's Saint Trina then. Is that all that's here? People are just dying. How are they dying? Try Snake Eye. How the hell are people dying there? Time for grass. Okay. Well, that's it, I suppose. That's everything. Okay. Yeah, I guess that's the DLC then. I guess we did it. I'm very mixed about it, honestly. Let's try Ashen, the new Dark Souls archetype in Yu-Gi-Oh. Yu-Gi-Oh, but it's Dark Souls. Yeah, I'm like... I'm honestly very mixed on this. Like, obviously there's a lot of content. The map is very large. The music is awesome. The artwork for it is awesome. Some of the boss fights are just so annoying. And then, I'm really not a fan of the Scatter Tree fragment thing. Maybe I missed something? No, that's everything. We got all the major bosses. We got all the remembrance bosses. But yeah. Like, we did all of... Unless, hold on, maybe there is something. Apparently we can craft and do something there, and it drops a talisman that gives you increased attack power when you put something to sleep. I don't care about that, really. But yeah, the tree fragment thing, I really don't like, but that's specifically because, like, you need to find every single tree fragment in order to reach the max Shadow Realm blessing. Like, these things are as important as smithing stones are. But they're scattered all over the fucking place, and it's like, they're hidden in every nook and cranny. Like, I thought they were just gonna be at, like, the yellow, like, crosses of light from Mikola's crosses. Because that's, you know, where you find your first one. But no, apparently they're just also on random corpses, and also, like, there's, like, loot goblins that could either have, you know, a fragment or just random-ass crafting materials. And, like, at that point, that's just fucking stupid. Yeah, like I said, like, some of the bosses are just obnoxious. Like, the final boss fight was just complete and utter fucking garbage. Like, the second phase is the worst boss fight I've ever played in a FromSoft game. Like, it's actually that bad. Like, I will say that as an actual, like, objective fact, that the phase 2 boss fight of the final boss is the worst boss that FromSoft has ever made. It's that fucking bad. And then there were other ones, like the tree avatar. That thing's just annoying because it does the same shit as Elden Beast, where it'll fly over to the other arena, other side of the arena, and then it starts throwing these, you know, spells at you that build up bleed if you don't dodge them correctly. Again, it's just annoying. There was, what was his name? Commander Gaius, I think was his name. The fucking dude riding the boar. So fucking irritating because of his... Literally just because of his charge move. Well, actually, no, there's two moves. His charge move, which just goes on for way too long. Literally, the first time that I fought him, I died because I got hit by his charge and stuck up against the wall. And I was like, eh, okay, well, I'm in hard knockdown and I'm invincible, so I'll just wait out the charge and get back up once he's done. No, he kept charging for like 5 or 6 seconds afterwards. He was charging for so long, my character fully stood up and lost his invincibility frames from being knocked down and then died. And then, of course, like, Commander Guy, he just has so many moves where he just jumps backwards again. It's just fucking obnoxious. Yeah, the tree fragments, the bosses. Honestly, the open world... That also kind of irritated me, too, because it's like, you know, hey, look at the map and see all the areas that you can get to. But in order to get to some of the areas, it's just so obtuse. Like, hold on. Let me show real quick. Like, probably the dumbest fucking thing. Yeah, so in the Shadowkeep here, we've got the Church District entrance right over here. You think it'd be as simple as just like, you know, you go to somewhere in the Shadowkeep and you just kind of like, you know, maybe there's something that leads into this little area here, right? No, you fucking idiot. What you actually need to do is find a ladder that takes you down into the basement so that you can exit out here and then you go all the way around. Go over to get up on... Or... Wait, no. I got that backwards. You actually go all the way over here, which is even worse. You go into these ruins, which leads into a hole, which goes down to the village here, and then you can go all the way over here to the church entrance. Like, why? Like, I'm sorry, that's just stupid. Like, that's just dumb, and it's like... You know, oh, how do we get over to this side of the map? Maybe there's a little, like, you know, cliff that you can walk down on this side of the map, right? No, you stupid fucking idiot. What you actually need to do, go back to the ruins here, but actually go up through here, and then through the poison swamp area, and then you can come out through here. Like, that's just an annoying way to get around the map. Like... I don't even know there's anything like that obnoxious in the lands between. Like, yeah, no, it's just kind of a straight line. Like, maybe the most annoying area to get to was probably Volcano Manor, but it was just because I couldn't find the ladder from the thing that you climb up here in order to get to it. That was basically it as far as like. Oh, and I guess there was also the medallion that you had to find to take a second elevator to get over here. That was about it, though. But, like, the entire, like, DLC was just, like, exactly like that. And it was kind of annoying. Like, honestly, the more that I think about it, the more that I'm just, like... DLC is just okay. And that feels bad to say. Like, I'm very mixed on this. I'm genuinely very mixed on this. I really don't know how to feel. Because, like, some of the bosses are cool. And then some of them are just, like, the most obnoxious bullshit that FromSoft has ever made to the point where it's not even fun to play them. I don't know. Maybe I'll have a better thought on him, like, as time goes on. But, like, it's... I'm very mixed on this. I'm very mixed on this DLC. Like, yes, there's a lot of content. Yes, there's a lot of bosses. But like I said before, when I was fighting Radahn, because I was just so fucking pissed about him, the bigger question is, are you having fun with it? And for a good chunk of the DLC, I don't really think I did. And that fucking sucks to say. I just hope that when they do, like, I don't know, Elden Ring 2 or something like that, dial down the bosses a little bit. Like, it almost seems like they're, like, some of the bosses feel like they're playing a completely different game from the player. And again, it just ends up being annoying more than anything. But yeah, okay, so that's my thoughts on the DLC. Very, very mixed. Very mixed opinion. Maybe on another playthrough I'll have a better idea of how to feel about it. But okay, let's see what won the poll. That is, if Straw Poll wants to actually fucking load. There we go. Alright. So it looks like Dark Souls 3 won. Yeah, it looks like Dark Souls 3 ended up winning. So, the reason Dark Souls 3 was on there was because I haven't played Ringed City yet. So, alright, it looks like for the next stream, we're gonna be doing Dark Souls 3 then. Because we gotta get to the Ringed City and play through that. Because for some reason, I just never played it. Like, I have it, I just never played it. So I guess we gotta fix that. Alright then. I guess that's it for today. I guess that's it for Elden Ring, huh? Kinda ending on a bit of a sour note, but you know, I guess it'd be like that sometimes. Like, honestly, I think the best way to describe this, like, I was watching a video by someone on YouTube. I think the name of the YouTube was, like, Joseph Anderson, I think. He did, like, an hour and a half long critique of the entirety of Elden Ring. And one of the things he said was that Elden Ring has the highest highs out of all the Souls games that he's played, but also the lowest lows that are so low that he's, like, genuinely concerned about the future of the series. And that's kind of how I feel, too. That's kind of how I feel as well. Alright, then. I mean, that's kind of a downer ending, but, you know, hopefully things, you know, hopefully the criticism about the bosses of Elden Ring actually, like, get through to, you know, Miyazaki and the devs. Because, like, yeah, while they want the game to be difficult, I think you should also focus on making the game fun and not having boss fights that make me think, you know, you have no idea how to make boss fights. That's basically it. All right. I'm going to go ahead and call it here for today then. So tomorrow we'll be starting up Dark Souls 3 because we got to get to the Ringed City DLC and do that. We'll see how that goes. I'm kind of excited for that because, again, for whatever reason, I don't know why, I just never got around to playing Ringed City. I played through Ashes of Ariandel, and even though it's, like, really short, I had fun with it. So, you know, hopefully, you know, Ringed City ends up better, ends up giving me a better impression than the Elden Ring DLC. All right, then. I'm going to actually call it for today then. So thank you all so much for stopping by. Thank you for watching. Have a great rest of your day, evening, or night, whatever it is where you are. And I'll see you all in Dark Souls 3. All right? All right, then. Peace.